Hey guys, welcome to our next art lesson. It is called The Dancing Cow. We have some really cool surprises for this video today. So get ready to not only be super creative and to draw a dancing cow, but to get a workout, as well as laugh a lot. So welcome and enjoy. All right, here's a couple cow jokes for you today. What did one dairy cow say to the other? Got milk? What did the secret agent cow say to the other? Are you utter cover? Sometimes you just need a silly laugh. And this is my all-time favorite. What do you get when you pamper a cow? Spoiled milk. So what you're gonna need for this art lesson, The Dancing Cow, is a piece of white paper, markers, but if you don't have them at home, colored pencils, crayons work just fine. If you do have canvas and paint, this might be something you want to paint. The finished product looks awesome. And your imagination. Okay, hey guys. So I have my paper ready and I have my marker. So what we do in class to make sure that everybody stays on the same page and we go the same speed for a teacher-directed lesson, which once again, it would be me giving instructions as what to draw and when to draw. Because we have some people that are really, really fast and some that, you know, just maybe take their time a little bit, I will have the students close their marker, put down their oil pastel or whatever art utensil we're using, and we will do some type of exercise. So that's what we have planned today. I will instruct you what to draw. When you are done with that, you will hear the exercise that you are to complete before we move on to the next drawing part. All right, so let's go ahead and start drawing our dancing cow. First, what we're going to do is draw the head by just making a U. And then we're gonna go ahead and do the two ears, connecting the head just like that. Then what I say is go ahead and close up your marker, set it down to do our first exercise. Hi, we decided to come outside to video the exercises for the dancing cow. This is Chase, my son, and you know me, I'm Jen. If a cat happens to run through, we'll introduce you to the outside cats. So Abby is going to read off the first exercise.
All right, 10 frog jumps.
All right, so the frog jumps, we get down low. You're welcome to move as you go. Ready, let's do it together. One, two. So just like you're a frog, you go red. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Okay, great job doing your exercise. So the next we're gonna do the horns. I'm just going to make sure that there will be some white that you could see through. Next part we're going to do is the nose. Just a big oval rectangle type shape. And then two nostrils. Okay, close up your marker. Ready for our next exercise.
20 jumping jacks.
20 jumping jacks. All right, let's go. One, two, three. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. All right, nice job with your exercise. Next, we're going to do the two eyes. And then we're going to fill in some of the spots on the cow. So this is where you can decide. You don't have to put them exactly where I'm putting them, but I'm gonna do three different brown spot or black spots on my cow head. All right, go ahead and close up your marker. Ready for exercise?
20 side to side jumps.
All right, 20 side to side jumps. We're gonna start to our right. Okay, ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Woo! All right, great job.
Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to do the body of our dancing cow. So what I decided we're going to do for this one is kind of have our cow kind of running to the side. So the very first thing with this part, we're going to draw the udders. So I'm going to do an oval shape right about there. And then I'm going to just go ahead and draw those udders. Then I'm going to connect the head to the udders right there, and then bring it around here back up to the top. All right, go ahead and put your marker down for our next exercise.
10 push-ups.
10 push-ups. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, great job. Now we're going to go ahead and curve this one arm, kind of like a boomerang, and then connect the bottom, and you can go ahead and fill in just like that. And then this other arm is going to come on up over here. Go ahead and fill that in. Let's go ahead and do the two bottom legs before we do our next exercise. So we're gonna have one just coming right where the udders are, down to the bottom. Go ahead and fill right that in. And then this is going to be a bent leg. And fill in just like that. All right, go ahead and put your marker down for our next exercise.
Run in place for 1 minute.
Okay, great job. Now we're going to go ahead and make some black spots on our cow, which now the cow is really coming together. It's looking pretty snazzy. Go ahead and put as many spots as you'd like. I like to do some along the edge of the cow just like that. And you can kind of imagine that it's continuing along the back side of the cow right there. And on the legs, I'm gonna just do two black spots on each leg, same for the arms. Okay, two over here. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and just draw our background, which is going to be a line that will be our horizon line. Everything to the bottom will be the grass. Everything to the top will be the sky. I am going to put a picket fence. I think it kind of breaks up the background. So in order to do that, I'm just going to make some posts. You can do it about 1 inch apart. If you want them a little bit further apart, you can do 2 inches. Just make these posts. And it's kind of cool to make them behind the cow. Makes it look a little bit more realistic. And then we're just going to connect them all together the best that you can. Try to make them as parallel as you can. Okay, then something that we forgot is to put a tail on the cow. So go ahead and put a tail on the cow, a couple pieces of hair, right like that. And that's kind of neat how the tail is kind of swaying so it looks like there's movement. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and color in our background. Okay, and while I'm coloring in my project, you will be able to listen to a song from Lori Berkner, one of my favorite kids singers. It is called Pig on Her Head. Enjoy.
Pig on her head, Lori's got a pig on her head, Lori's got a pig on her head, she keeps it there all day.
Oink, 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 oink.
My dad has got a cow on his head, my dad has got a cow on his head, my dad has got a cow on his head, he keeps it there all day.
What does it say?
My mom has got a sheep on her head. My mom has got a sheep on her head. My mom has got a sheep on her head.
My sister's got an alligator on her head. My sister's got an alligator on her head. My sister's got an alligator on her head. She keeps it there all day. What does it say? Snap, 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 snap. My brother's got an elephant on his head. My brother's got an elephant on his head. My brother's got an elephant on his head. He keeps it there all day.
Little bunny that's pooping jelly beans. Well, there he goes. Okay, so thank you for joining in on this really fun, awesome project. I'm trying to do some really basic, easy projects that turn out so vibrant and awesome. So once again, send me your finished product. I am loving what I'm seeing. Great job, kiddos. Bye.